got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed,
you just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you got a friend in me.
Yeah, you've got a friend in me.
It's so great to be back with you all. We are having a bit of a late winter resurgence here, but I bet by the next time we're here with a new show, all the animals at the Rutland County Humane Society will be heading out onto those enclosed porches and enjoying the sunshine and the warm temperatures. And to tell us all about what is happening at the shelter right now and who's available for adoption, let's welcome our good friend Beth Saradarian. Hi, Beth.
Hello, Steph. How are you?
I'm good. I'm dreaming about the animals being out on the porches.
And us being with them, right?
And us being with them. I want to be on my own porch with a warm breeze blowing.
I know. Instead of snow.
We'll get there,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we will get there. Absolutely.
One thing you know about Vermont weather is it changes. It changes rapidly and kind of like the conditions at the shelter, right? Just wait and something will change.
Something will change.
And your best friend will come along. Speaking of best friends, you have man's best friend right here and woman's best friend. What a handsome doggy and a nice boy you have with you.
I know. This is my friend Max, and he's such a good boy.
He's
just
so
been
good.
Fabulous today. Can you
and
turn
he
around?
Loves everybody here at the studio. He was
he was
and this is a chance for me to say thank you too to our staff here at PEGTV, but yeah. He was visiting and loving up with Rich and Jim and Chelsea and Sarah, and he was just getting so much love. But he's an extrovert. He was looking around the corner like, okay, who's going to come and love me next?
Right. I'm ready for someone else to pet me and rub my belly.
He's such a friendly boy.
He's such a good guy. Yeah, he was great in the car. And he's about 4 years old, and he's a lab mix. And he has the exact same face as my Border Collie Australian Shepherd mix. So you never know what's in there, really. But he's rolling around and getting belly rubs, and he's just... He's a funny fellow, but he's a staff favorite. Come here, Max. Come here, handsome. Good boy. And he loves treats. And so he'll be hanging out with me today. And I think he thinks he's a lap dog as well, because he's tried a couple times to get at least half his body up on my lap. So
yes,
we'll see how the show goes.
And he's just really, I can say, so friendly, so handsome. He's sleek and healthy and just a lovely dog.
Just got the little white tip on his tail. Little white tip at the end of your tail, too.
Aww.
He's a good boy. So we do have some other dogs in addition to you, Mr. Man. So we have dogs and cats and some small animals to talk about as well. So
let's get started.
Just jump right in.
Yeah.
So our first dog is Winston, and Winston takes a little while to warm up to new people. So Amelia, our shelter manager, is in with Winston, and once he gets to know you, he's just a lovely, lovely fella. So he's about 4 years old. He's a neutered male. And he is a pit bull boxer mix, and he has the cutest ears. right now, Winston is looking for a foster home where he can just continue to settle in. When he first got here, he was really, really kind of stressed out, and he was struggling a lot. He's come a long, long way. And for those staff members and volunteers, who he's gotten to know, he's been absolutely wonderful. He plays outside, he takes treats, he, you know, shakes and you know, goes for walks, and he loves them, but he just needs time to settle in and get to know you and just, you know, we don't know a lot about his past, but he has, you know, issues trusting new people, I think I would say. But then once he gets to the point where he trusts you and he gets to know you and he feels comfortable, then he's like a totally different dog.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, so a big fellow with a big camera coming in probably wouldn't have been the best thing
for
him.
Yeah, so actually Andrew's, he's filming through the window.
Yeah.
Yep. So, and even that Winston was not quite sure about.
You could tell by the ears, a little bit of suspicion there.
Yep.
But.
But before that, Amelia was in there with him, and they went outside in the exercise pen area, and Winston was jumping up and down in the snow, and he was having a grand old time. So he's a special fellow, and we adore him, but he's just, he knows how to sit and shake and lie down, and he's just needs a quiet foster home or a quiet home, adoptive home where there's not a lot going on and where he can just kind of be him and take time to settle in.
Well, that's what's so nice about, being able to work with shelter staff when you want to adopt is you are working with people who know these animals quite well and have been able to observe them and know the kind of home that would be best for them. And so rely on that expertise, it's a really good tool. Yeah. And sometimes we fall in love with a certain look or a certain type and you have to realize, maybe that's not the right placement for you though. And you have to be patient and that can be hard sometimes because sometimes we want what we want, but it's not necessarily what's best for that particular animal. So that's when the shelter staff is a really good resource for us.
So that's our friend Winston, and we adore him, and so we're just going to take our time, and we'll find the right place
for him.
Find
him the right place.
Yep.
So cute.
So up next is Naya, and she is about 6 years old, and she's a spayed female German Shepherd. She weighs about 68 pounds, and if you are a Shepherd lover, you should meet our friend Naya. She loves everybody she meets, and she greets you with a happy wag of a tail, as you can see there. She was very interested in, so one of the treats went under the door. So she was like, but it's over there. So she was smart. She knew it was over there and she was trying to figure out how she can possibly get it. She was brought to us back in early February because she wasn't getting along with one of the other dogs in her household. I would say do some research on German Shepherds and the breed if you are interested in adopting it and you don't know much about the breed. But, German Shepherds are very smart. She is, super friendly. I don't actually know her all that well. And she was great with me this morning. And she likes her toy. She was just trying to figure out where the heck all those treats were that she was looking for. She likes to learn. She's smart. And, regular exercise is important. Stimulating games and teaching her things is going to be important with any dog really, but especially with, Shepherds who are really smart and need that mental stimulation. So beautiful, beautiful dog. And so that's our friend Naya.
They are such beautiful dogs and such natural athletes, you know, and it seems like anytime you see any of those challenge shows on TV about, dogs going through all these agility and learning challenges, you always see, some sort of a German Shepherd or Belgian Malinois or something like that. They're just really beautiful, smart dogs.
Yep. So that's our friend Naya.
Good protectors of families, too. They tend to be pretty, pretty protective of the ones that they love.
Yep. So up next is Wanda. Oh, Wanda's rear end.
Wanda.
Wanda is about a year old. She's a spayed female pit bull. She weighs about 60 pounds, and she arrived as a stray, and nobody came to claim her. She is a hoot and a half. She's on the go. She's sweet and funny and just silly. She just was like, ooh, I like treats. I'll sit. I'll jump in the air. I'll do whatever you want. She was very curious and interested in everything going on in the room, and just a funny. I think she slobbered all over the lens, just out and about. What's going on? What can I do to get a treat? I want to be with you. Let's go. Let's go. She was just like a whirling dervish, really, just a funny, funny girl, and very sweet, and just a staff favorite, and jumped on the couch, off the couch, on the. She looks like all over the place.
She just wants to take part in everything.
Yeah.
All at once.
Yeah. She's got a sweet little face. She's just a cute dog. She greets people nicely, just loves everybody she meets.
She is a cutie.
She's a cutie. So that is our friend Wanda. Up next is Kai. Kai is about 9 months old, and he, I should say. is a Siberian Husky, about 45 pounds, and Kai came in with another Husky, which we'll talk about in a few minutes. And so Kai and Ranger, which is the other one, are a little shy and haven't really been socialized very well. So everything seems pretty new to them, and they're on the thin side as well. So we are working on, you know, introducing them to new places and people and things. And so they did a lot of new things. You know, they met new people and cameras and treats and toys and things like that were all kind of new to them. So
ear.
I know. Kai's ear is just hysterical.
Oh, it's just so lovable.
So I would say that people who are interested in Kai or Ranger should get, you know, do some research on the breed. So, you know, Huskies tend to, you know, they're high energy, they're on the go, certainly not, you know, necessarily your basic couch potato dog. You know, they can be escape artists. So, you know, do your research. They're lovely dogs. I mean, I had a Siberian Husky once. They're lovely. But you just want to know what you're getting so that there are no surprises. I got a little kiss today from Kai. So she's, you know, starting to trust, and she definitely wants to kind of learn and be in the middle of everything, but she's still not quite sure. Yeah. Not quite sure, but she's got some beautiful markings. She's kind of like brown, red, and then some tan and some white. So she's really cool. And they were having some fun in the snow the other day too. So.
Oh, they love the snow and the cold. And you're right. They're so smart, and they're not for everybody. You have to know what you're dealing with a Husky. But for folks who love them and know them, they're just so rewarding. You know.
So that
beautiful too.
Isn't she? I know.
Yeah.
He's so handsome. So that is our friend Kai. And up next is my little boyfriend here, Max, who just kind of belched in my face.
Thank you,
You're
Max.
You're digesting all those yummy treats I gave you. So this is Max. He's about 4 years old. He's a neutered male lab mix, and he weighs about 70 pounds. And he is your basic happy-go-lucky pup. So I got this hedgehog toy from the back that has one of those squeaky things in it. It's like the size of your head. I mean, this thing is huge. And Max found it and just was like, this is my thing. This is the best thing ever. And I'm just going to carry it around for the next few minutes. Aww. So he found the best toy ever. So he's lived with both dogs and cats, and he did well with them. He doesn't like being alone, so he's looking for a home where he is around somebody a lot. And he likes being wherever people are, and we saw that in the studio today for sure. He's looking for, you know, a hiking or a jogging partner. He loves the outdoors, and you know, he's got lots of energy, and he just wants to be with people and be part of, you know, the family. I think an active family would be good. I think he'd love to go to soccer games and do all those things and be part of the family. So
I think he wants to take that hedgehog home too.
Oh my gosh, it was so funny. He just found it, and then he was like, I think I'm just gonna hang on to this.
It's funny how there's always a prized toy. Yeah. In our house, one Fozzie will get the prized toy and he'll bring it over to his bed, and then Birdie's bed is inside of her crate, but the door's always open, so she'll go and take the toy from his bed and put it in the farthest back corner of her crate and then guard it, and then it's just back and forth. You see the toy, you know, and they have what, 20 toys, and there's always the one that everyone wants.
Yep.
And that toy can always change too.
Right.
You see it here in the community cat rooms. There's always that one toy you get out that everyone is like, I want to play
with
that toy.
Yeah, that's the one I want today. Yep.
Well, I hope that when Max gets his new home, he gets to take his hedgehog with him.
That's right. So that's our friend Max. And the last dog we have is Ranger, and he is the other Husky. So he has totally different coloring than Kai. So he also is about 9 months old. And similar in terms of needing some confidence and needs to learn, you know, about going places and meeting new people, and collars and leashes, I think, are new to them as well. And so everything is new and exciting, and they're handling all of this very well. You know, they're he's never seen a hedgehog that big either. So Ranger has more of the more quote-unquote traditional husky coloring with the black and the gray and the white, but although the copper ones are also out there as well, but he's super handsome too. But again, learning all about all new things, and but again, do research on the breed, and just know the type of dog that they are if you're interested in adopting. But they are lovely, lovely dogs, and so.
Boy, he's handsome.
Isn't he handsome? Yeah.
Really kind of a classic husky look.
He's interested in kind of getting to know me, and then he's like, not quite sure, but hey, I'm going to come back. And then, yeah, you've got that treat thing, and then they spit it out, and then they're quite sure what to do. So.
Aww.
So that's a quick overview of the dogs we have up for adoption, although we have more at the shelter and always getting more in, so definitely keep an eye on the website or give us a call. And
it's a great bunch.
Yeah, we have some really nice dogs right now, for sure. Right? So and we do have some cats to talk about, as well as some small animals, and Max is like, I'd like more treats, please. Do you think I forgot about you? Do you think? Can you shake? I'll give you one because you're cute. You got a freebie.
Freebie.
Alrighty, our first cat is Petunia.
Aww.
She was the star of the show today. I don't even think I'm going to talk. She's about a year old. She's a calico. She weighs about 8 pounds. And she zips around the room playing with toys, and she did not disappoint today.
She's a great cat. Look at her. Aww. This girl could give a kitten a run for its money, right? She can play.
She's so funny today.
We're just taking a break here to watch this adorable cat do her thing. Oh my goodness.
She gets like all wrapped around the cat. She was just so funny. She was kind of like, I don't know what to do now. I'm kind of stuck. And then she just kept going.
And then the other cats are like, okay, what's happening over here?
She got herself wrapped around this scratching post. Oh, it was so funny.
She's adorable.
She was a hoot. So she actually was brought to us as a transport from Pennsylvania. So she is doing her thing here in Vermont and getting along with the other cats. And she is a spunky gal, I will say that. And she will entertain you and your family if that is what you're looking for. So that's our friend Petunia.
She's not going to fade into the woodwork.
She's not going to fade into the woodwork. She'll be the star of your household, that's for sure.
She's a cute cat with a cute name, too.
That's great. So that's our friend Petunia. Up next is Calypso, and Calypso is about 2 years old, and she's a domestic short hair buff. She weighs about 6 pounds. And she came to us as a stray, and she is always hiding. The other day we had like this big stuffed animal cat, and she was like underneath a paw. Like you can't even find her, and then suddenly like the foot moves, and then like you see her head stick out, and so she was really trying to decide if she should come out and play with this toy today. And she really wanted to. But then she wasn't really quite so sure.
So if you like to play hide and seek, this is the cat for you.
She was like, hmm.
She's kind of camouflaging herself in there, too, with the colors.
And then she was...
She's tempted.
She was so funny.
Aww.
She's so cute.
She's really cute.
Isn't she so
cute?
Look at
that little face.
Look at her little ears. She's like, oh, my ears are out. Does that count? And they get...
The little paw comes out.
Oh, so funny. So she is probably looking for a quieter household as opposed to Petunia, who would be the star of the show. But I think having another cat in her home might be a good thing. She's doing fine with the other cats
would
in
here. Would
draw
her out a little bit.
Yeah, draw her out a little bit. So, but she's usually in a good hiding spot. So she tends to blend in because I don't know that she knows that she's blending in, but the stuffed animal was the same color as her and you could barely find her either. So,
so she's a chameleon cat.
She is. She is indeed. So that is our friend Calypso. You didn't get a chance to see the rest of her body, but you got a chance to see her head at least. And up next is Pepper, and Pepper is about 8 years old, and she is a medium-haired black and white cat who weighs about 8 pounds, and she is usually one of the first ones to greet you when you enter the community cat room, but today she decided that she was in her spot and she was not going to move, and that if I wanted her to play, that I had to bring the toy to her.
You all have such good hiding spots in those community cat rooms,
right,
too.
She was like, well, if you want me to play, you're going to have to bring this fish right here to me. She was a transport from West Virginia. And don't let her age fool you. She is spunky as can be at age 8, and she's getting along with the other cats in the cat room. She's a little independent, so she's not as, you know, outgoing as spunky as certainly as Petunia, but she does like to play with toys and will entertain herself, so she's certainly not going to be in the middle of things like Petunia, but she's a sweet older lady and loves her toys and will happily play just in her spot.
Yeah, and we all know some really long-lived cats who have been healthy and well for many, many years. So 8 is not too old at all for a healthy kitty cat. She has got a cute little face peeking out of there.
So cute. So that is our friend Pepper. Up next are George and Littlebit. And they are 7-month-old kittens. George is the orange male, and Littlebit is the black female, and they are a bonded pair. So we are hoping that they go to their new home together. And they were not on the same level for today's game of playing with the fish. So either one was missing out or the other was, but they get along nicely, and so we want them to go to their homes together. So these are the only kittens, and they're 7 months old, so they're not like teeny tinies that we often have, but these are the only ones we have right now. But I do know that we had a pregnant mom come in, and so we're starting to get the phone calls about kittens. So I do know that kitten season will be beginning soon, I should
feels
say.
Feels like it starts sooner and ends later these days, doesn't it?
I know. Yep. So,
but kittens are coming, and in the meantime, we got this cute pair.
Yes. And honestly, we've talked about it before, kittens do well in pairs.
Yes.
Because they entertain each other.
Yeah, and think about that. If you have to go off and leave them for a bit or go to work, then they have one another, and that's a nice thought.
Yep.
Oh, they are cute. She wants to get in on the action.
So that is Littlebit and George. And then the other cats that we have, the last cats we have, are Helen and Jasper. And we would like them to go home together as well. Helen is a 5-month-old domestic short hair little kitten. And Jasper is about 1.5 years old, and he is a gray tiger weighing about 9 pounds. They are both feline leukemia positive. And so Jasper, think we knew when he came in he was feeling leukemia positive, and then as it turns out, Helen also was. And we put them in together, and they got along swimmingly. So, and feline leukemia cats can live a long, healthy life, especially when they're with other cats that are feline leukemia positive. So, we ask people who are interested to talk to the staff and talk to the veterinarian and learn more about feline leukemia positive cats, but these guys are up for adoption and they're doing great, and so we would ask that you just consider adopting feline leukemia positive cats because they can live a long, healthy life. So these guys, we want to go home together, and they both were kind of sad until we put them together, and aww. So now they're really enjoying each other's company.
That's
and one
wonderful.
Is very large at like 9 pounds, and then Helen is like 4 pounds.
Yes, she's so petite.
She's
they're
so
an
tiny.
Adorable pair.
Yeah, they're cute. So so that that's our little pair of Helen and Jasper. So they're cute. And then we have some new rabbits to talk about. We have Softy and Pieball. And they are about a year old. They're females, and they're Holland Lops. And they're very social and active bunnies. They were surrendered to us because their previous owners were moving, and they couldn't take them along. And they've been very well socialized and handled frequently, which is great. Very enthusiastic when you come over. You can give them snacks. You can pick them up. They're active and playful. And we would like them to go home together as well. And the coloring on them is really, really cool. The gray and white one is gorgeous. And the other one is kind of caramel colored. And the gray one just keeps like spinning around, like hopping around.
They are so cute.
Aren't they?
Yeah. Holland Lop bunnies are really cute.
Yeah.
And just a reminder for folks that bunnies and chicks and ducks are not Easter toys or gifts. They are pets that need to be treated like any other pet with the commitment of their lifetime. So,
and do research on these small animals as well.
Yes.
Like it's there's a lot to, you need to spend time with them, and there's
yes.
a lot to the cleaning and care of them. So it's they're indoor pets, and so you just want to make sure that you're thinking it through.
Yeah, they live longer than you think. Their commitment is more than you often think.
Right,
so,
right.
And I think attitudes are changing on that. So,
right.
Great. Adorable.
Lots of chins.
I see lots of chins. Lots of chins, yes.
And then last up, we have two gerbils. We have Jimmy and Chew, which are shoes.
Jimmy Chews. Yes,
shoes.
Very expensive shoes.
Yes. So, they were brought to us because their owner moved, and I think that other animals, I think there were dogs in the household. Oops. It was too stressful for these guys, which I would imagine. So they're so cute.
Gerbils are really cute.
They really are.
Yeah.
So there's they're both females, and there's just so much bedding in there. They can hide. You're just like, where'd they go? Where are you? And then they pop their head up somewhere else, and so.
Well, you don't often have gerbils, so let's for folks who are interested, let's keep these two in mind.
Yep.
Couldn't be any cuter, and ready. They're ready to go.
They are.
We have about a minute left if you want to put up the wish list.
Yes, let's do that. Thank you.
So if folks are out shopping, they can get paper towels, and they can get trash bags, soft chewy dog treats, sturdy dog toys, cat toys, of course, too, some canned dog food, and some canned kitten food. So those are wonderful things to pick up while you're out shopping. Always check the website for Rutland County Humane Society or give a call to the staff because things are always changing.
Mm-hmm.
But you have a wonderful selection up for adoption right now. Dogs and cats and rabbits and gerbils.
Yes, a wide variety right now. For
yes,
sure.
Absolutely. Yeah. Thank you, Beth, so much for joining us
today. Oh, happy to
and
be
Max
here.
Too.
Yeah.
Thanks to our staff here at PEGTV for hosting us as always, and thanks to our loyal viewers for watching Pet Partners. We'll see you next time.